Hey loves, welcome to my channel. My name is Chechi. If you're a new subscriber, welcome, welcome. Please don't make it your last. You can also subscribe. Thanks for sticking around with me. So in today's video, I'm very, very angry. I'm literally angry because I'm going to be talking about this soap, which a lot of YouTubers have claimed that it is amazing. It does this and it does that for them. Well, it ruined my skin. I have more acne than I actually always have, and I'm just pissed. Let's get right into the video. I know you might notice a change in my background. That is because we've not had power supply. Like, I don't know what's happening in Lagos. No power supply, so I'm just looking for a natural lighting, and this is where I could get something like that. So yeah, that's why the setting has changed. I hope that doesn't deviate your attention from the content of this video. So I know a lot of people will be like, no, this soap helped me, this is Dove soap, and it's the original version, so it's not like I bought fake product or something. So something that I found out about this soap is that it is not good for all skin types. You might have dry skin, and when you use this, it's going to be good for you. And also, all the ingredients used in this soap are all comedogenic ingredients, which means they are going to clog your pores. That was one of the mistakes that I made. I'm pissed right now because I see that a lot of YouTubers who do reviews and also influencers, you don't actually use the product, and you're telling people that are subscribed to your channel, you're telling people that are listening to you that they should use the product, while you yourself, you haven't tested it, you don't know how good it is on your skin, and you're not advising people to use it. One thing that I always make sure that I do is I make sure that I always use the products that I recommend, that I've applied it on my skin. I make sure that I put it on my skin and I see the way it reacts on my skin before I inform people about the product. So yeah, so everything in this soap is comedogenic. They are going to clog your pores. And I wasn't even interested in checking out the product because I had the intention that this product was going to be good, because a lot of people have claimed that it worked for them. I watched lots of videos, and as a YouTuber, I was just inclined to try it out, you know. Some people said it's good for acne, why not? People that had 10 million views on their videos, 20 million views, I just assumed that, okay, they were professionals already, so let me just listen to what they say, and I bought this. So I started using it on my skin, and my skin was just, I was having more acne on my face, and I was like, okay, why is this happening? I thought I was not supposed to have acne when I used this, so what is going on? Why am I having acne again? So I just decided, okay, I'm going to check out the ingredients in this product. Let me know if something is in it that I'm allergic to. Then I go in, and there are lots of names there that I cannot pronounce. So I'm just going to read it out from where I've written it down. So the first one here is sodium lauryl isothionate. So this is popularly known as SLI. It is derived from coconuts and used as a cleansing agent and also a foaming agent. So this is derived from coconuts, and coconuts can clog your pores. The comedogenic rating of coconut is 4. It is going to clog my pores because my skin is acne prone, and when I use it, it is definitely going to clog my pores. Why did no one say that? Why? Why did no one tell me that, okay, if you have acne prone skin, you shouldn't use it? Why? Alright, the next one here is stearic acid. So I googled it, and stearic acid is fatty acid in animal and plants, typically palm oil or coconut. Another comedogenic ingredient. Another ingredient that is going to clog my pores. Palm oil is rated 4 on the comedogenic rating list, which means it's going to clog my pores. That is the second ingredient that I'm reading out. The third ingredient here is lauric acid, and lauric acid is a fatty acid within coconut oil. Like, the major content of this soap is coconut oil and palm oil, and it's not as if these things are bad, but it's not for all skin types. So if you're trying to recommend something to someone, make sure that you inform them that, okay, this is for dry skin, this is for combination skin. If you know you have acne, do not use this product. But no one said that. And when I used it, I really had acne. I don't know if you can see the acne on my face right now. I have loads of acne here. Maybe the ring light will not like allow you to see it properly, but I'm going to take a picture so you can see what I'm talking about. So I had more acne, and that was what prompted me to even try to find out what this soap actually contains. So the next thing here is sodium palmate. You already know by the name, sodium palmate. You already know it's something that has to do with palm oil. And it is it's derived from a mixture of acid in palm oil. So another comedogenic rating of 4, again in one product. The next one is sodium stearate. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but yeah, sodium stearate. And sodium stearate, they are vegetables obtained from coconut and palm oil. A moment of silence for my face. Like, if I kept on using this product, I don't know what would have happened to my skin. The next one is something that I cannot even pronounce. Let me try and call it cocamidroprofil betaine. Okay, it is naturally derived liquid produced from raw coconuts, which is combined with something else to create a surfactant. So another coconut and another coconut. Okay, the next thing is and also that's cocamidroprofil is also used to thicken the product, you know, hydrate and nourish the skin. That is one of its functions. So another one is sodium palm kernels. You already know that this is another form of palm oil. And when I googled it, it said sodium palm kernel is derived from a mixture of fatty acid from palm kernel oil. So there's a difference between palm oil and palm kernel oil. So palm oil is gotten from the fruits, while palm kernel oil is gotten from the nuts. So that is the difference, but they are all rated 4 on the comedogenic rating list. So glycerin is actually okay, because glycerin is extracted from animal fat as well as vegetable fats. It is an excellent moisturizer for skin. We already know this. So the last one I'm going to talk about now, this is not the only thing that I contain, but these are like the prominent ones that I really really want to talk about. And sodium chloride, commonly known as salt. So you can see that everything in this product, like this product, it doesn't mean that it is bad, don't get me wrong, it doesn't mean that it is really really bad. It just means that it is not for all skin type. It's not for my skin. So like, YouTubers, please, we are one. Just that when you're trying to recommend something, make sure that you find everything about it, all the old information, so that your subscribers will not be misled. So now I have acne, and I have to start, you know, taking care of my skin again, pampering my skin, so that I can get rid of that acne, which is not nice at all. So I'm not happy at all that I have to go through using this soap. And I spent, how much did I buy it? I bought like a pack for this is the small one. Let me show you guys. This is the small one, and it's the original one because it's pure white. Like, that is how you know the original ones. They are usually pure white. So that's it. So I don't even know what I'm going to do with the soap anymore. So what I just started doing was that I stopped using it on my face, I started using it on my body, and still it was clogging my pores on my lips. So I just started using body scrubs so I could open up my pores and stuff. So that's it. So before you use a product, before you recommend a product to anyone, make sure that you find out the ingredients in it. This is not good for acne prone skin. Don't use this. Combination skin, don't use it. So this is the advice I'm going to give you guys. Don't use it if you already have acne. If you know that you are prone to acne, please do not use it, because you're going to develop more acne. So yeah, so that's the story. That's my story time. Now I have a ruined face that I have to take care of again. So I hope this was informative. I hope that you find it helpful. Until next time, I love you guys. Bye.